seawater. This is semi-seawater. And what we're going to do is we're going to spill.
Those of us who live and work around the Gulf of Mexico remember all too well the horrifying images we saw last year after the Deepwater Horizon explosion. Those images of oil-soaked waterfowl, of sea creatures suffering from the effects of the spill. And that's when we all learned the word dispersant. It wasn't a part of our vocabulary for most of us until that time. And we learned a little bit about the use and usefulness of dispersants on occasions like that. Well, that was not news to our School of Polymers and High Performance Materials. They have, in fact, been very busy in their lab working with and developing dispersants and finding quick applications for its use. I'm here with Dr. Bob Lochhead, who's director of the school and professor of polymer science and high performance materials. So tell us about this product.
First of all, it's completely natural. It all comes from plants. It's completely biodegradable, so we don't need to worry too much about it being there forever. But the real important thing about it is that it will disperse all oils, not like the one that they're using now, which may not disperse all the oils, and it's not a wetting agent. The way to think about this is the existing ones are kind of like the oils, like a billiard ball. It's smooth, and with a little detergent on the outside. What we do is we stick polymers on the outside of the oil droplets, like a tennis ball, like putting the fuzz on a tennis ball. But the fuzz now is actually water-loving polymers. These polymers absolutely love water, and they stick to the oil droplet. And because they love water, they don't spread on oil surfaces like birds, and it keeps it in the water column. But that fuzz allows the microbes to get in to eat the oil, and they also eat the fuzz as well, eventually.
How would this dispersant be applied?
That's one thing we're working on. As we go to the prototype, it could be either sprayed or it may just be laid on. Our goal now, the Deepwater Horizon was a catastrophe, but it is a catastrophe that maybe happens every 20, 30 years. But there's oil being spilled in U.S. waters and other waters all the time, from tankers, from accidents, small amounts of oil. And so what we're trying to do is say, how would we make a kit? That would be part of a prototype. How do you make a kit that you put on every oil rig, you put on every tanker, and you put next to every pipeline, so in the event of a spill, you can then apply that. Now, you may just throw it on the spill, you may spray it on the spill. What we need to do is look at, and that's part of the product development, say, if you were the person there when a spill occurred, what is the best way to put it on the spill? Do you just pour it on? Maybe easier to pour it on. I mean, you can't always call up an airplane and say, spray this.
Yeah.
So we probably have several product forms depending on the size of the spill and the type of people who need to deal with the spill and the type of equipment that they have. And that's all part of this year of working towards a working prototype.
Well, you know, at a research university, we're here to solve problems.
Yes.
And it's pretty amazing to see how you and your scientists are working together with others to solve a very real problem that caused us all a great deal of anxiety mm-hmm. about a year ago, and we hope never happens again.
Right.
Is there anything else you'd like to tell us
well,
about?
Well, just one other thing. You know, it's fun. That's the other thing. It's a lot of fun doing this. It's a serious situation. But you can still have fun even when you're dealing with very serious situations. But the other thing it allows us to do is to educate the 21st century scientific workforce. We're showing people how to use new techniques that just weren't available to me and develop them so they can compete in the world. And hopefully, as we develop this, we'll develop a cadre and an expertise here that will attract companies here and give us jobs in southern Mississippi. So that's the goal.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Bob Lochhead, solving problems and having fun doing it here in the Accelerator.